Hi everybody, welcome to NuttX channel. Today I will show how to use SDCard over SDIO interface. So today we will use the native SDIO interface to read and write to SDCard. So let's get started. Open the Linux terminal. Enter inside NuttX space. NuttX, execute make this clean to clear previous configuration. Now we need to verify if our board has support to SDCard over SDIO interface. So ls configs stm32f4 discovery SRC, STM32, SDIO.c. Okay, our board has support. So now we can execute the board configuration. Tools, configure.sh, STM32F4, discover/NSH. Now we can execute make menu config to select the options to enable the SDCard over SDIO interface. Make menu config. First, we need to change the build host platform to Linux. We also need to enable the USB console interface. If you don't know how to do that, please watch the previous video explain how to do it. And I will speed up the video now. Okay, the USB console option is enabled. Now I will show how to enable the SDCard over SDIO interface. Enter inside system type, STM32 peripheral support, and enable SDIO interface. We can exit. Now move down to SDIO configuration. We need to enable the internal pull-ups because the SDCard adapter I am using doesn't have the pull-ups resistors mounted in the board. So we need to enable the internal pull-up to get the SDCard working. Now we can exit again, go to RTOS features, go to work queue support, enable high priority worker thread, exit, go to RTOS hooks and enable custom board driver initialization. Also enable the board initialization thread. Now we can exit. Exit again. Go to device drivers. Select the MMC SD driver support. Now we need to disable the write protection pin because we are not using it, and disable the SPI transfer because we are not using SPI, we are using SDIO interface, so we need to select the SDIO transfer support. So here basically that is it. Okay, now we need to go to file system, enable the FAT file system. We can also select the FAT upper and lower case names and long file name support. Now we can exit and exit again and save. Execute make to compile the source code. Okay, the NuttX source code was compiled. Now we can flash the firmware inside the board. Ctrl R, open OCD. Ctrl L to move up. And press Enter to flash it. Okay, the firmware was flashed. Now I will show how to connect the SD card to the STM32F4 discovery board. You need to connect 9 pins. The VCC 3.3 volts, the GND, PB15, PC9, PC8, PC12, PD2, PC11 and PC10. This is how I wired my board. I used short wires, less than 10 centimeters or 4 inches, and soldered directly in the SD card adapter board. Okay, the SD card adapter is connected to the STM32F4 discovery board. Now I will connect the USB cable to the micro USB. And we will reset the board. And let's see if the TTY ACM0 was detected. Okay. It was detected. Now we can run minicon. Change the serial port to TTY ACM0. Press Enter 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Let's see if the SD card driver was created. ls/dev. Okay, the device driver initialized correctly and create the device file. Now we can mount it. Mount vfetch/dev/mmc/sd0/2/mnt. Okay, it is mounted. Now we can see what is inside the SD card. Okay, there is a test file there, let you show what's inside it. TXT. Okay, the content of the file was printed in the screen. Now we can also create some file. For example, hello world to MNT. hello.txt. Let's see. There are two files now. We can see the content of the hello.txt. So basically that is it. I hope you had enjoyed this video. If you are not subscribed to NuttX channel, please subscribe and see you in the next video. Bye bye.